with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at creating secure passwords for your Mac for things other than online passwords. So last week I released a new short book available in iBooks and on Amazon called The Practical Guide to Mac Security. And this is one of the tips that I give in that book. So say you're on the web and you want to create a new password for something you're doing. So say I'm signing up for a Facebook account for the first time. I click in the password field and I see that Safari suggests a password. And I should use a password either from Safari suggestion or from another third-party app like 1Password or LastPass, because a randomly generated password is going to be so much more secure than anything I can think up. So I could do that, but what if I have to create a password for something that's not on the web, that's in an app, or maybe in the real world, not even on my Mac? Well, on your Mac, those passwords are stored in your keychain. And you don't ever have to actually access the keychain directly because you've got Safari doing that for you. But you can go to an app you've got on your Mac called Keychain Access. I'm going to search for it basically by using Spotlight here and run it. And you can see I could find it here in my application folder. I believe it's in the utilities subfolder there, but it's just easier to search for it like this. And I've got all sorts of things in here that Safari has saved, as well as things other apps and different things have saved that use the keychain. But what if I want to use this to create something that isn't on my computer, or it's in an app that's not using keychain? I can go to File, New Password Item, and create a new password here. Now the cool thing is I can actually store this in my keychain. And since I only have access to my keychain when I'm logged into my Mac with my password, this is secure. So I can just create something here and create a password for it. But the best part of this is that I can hit this little key button here and bring up the password assistant and generate a random secure password. So the password assistant has a lot of different controls. You can set a type of password, like something memorable, something that's random but it's got bits in it that will help you remember it. This is good for something where you can't use a reminder or something very easily. You have to memorize it. But you can also go to something like just some random letters and numbers, numbers only. This is very useful. Say if you need to generate a PIN for your ATM card, you can use this. Of course, it only goes down to 8 characters because anything less really isn't that secure. But you can just take the first 4 or something like that, and at least they're randomly generated. And you can go through all of these, and it will tell you the quality of the password depending upon the length and what you've selected. And then once you have this, you can easily copy and paste. Now, if you want more suggestions, you can click here and you can see that it gives you a whole list of them. So for instance, if I want to do something memorable and for some reason I didn't like that, I could just click here and choose the second one instead. So let's create one here. I'm going to create something, let's say my ATM pin. And I'm just going to just call it that. I'm going to generate a numbers only password and just take the first 4 there. And then what will happen is it automatically places it in here in the password field. And I can now add it. I have to give it an account name, so I'll just call it my bank add. And now you can see it adds it in here. It's under passwords category here. I mean, under login means that I have to be logged in to be able to access this. So I can always go in here, open this up, click show password, and it's going to ask me to enter in my login password, and then I can see my ATM pin. So it's a good way to store these things, especially if you need to generate something randomly and then make sure you have it somewhere secure in case you forget it. So check out my book, The Practical Guide to Mac Security, and it's got all sorts of good information about things like this, about different ways to protect your online accounts and your Mac with good passwords, protecting yourself from malware, protecting yourself from scams and tricks, and backing up your Mac, protecting it from other physical disasters, all sorts of other miscellaneous questions that people have about Mac security. It's only $2.99 in the iBooks store from Apple, or also the Amazon store for Kindle.